Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to the channel. Tonight we're going to be installing the OLM carbon fiber grill trim. This is specifically geared towards the 2015-2017 WRX or STI. Mainly because the front bumper and the grill changed from 2018 plus. So this is only for anybody that has a 15 to 17. And I do actually prefer the 2018 bumper, but I have a 2017, so I kind of just missed out on the LCI, the updates that they did for 2018. But this is, again, this is by Subispeed. This is the OLM carbon fiber grill trim. So it's that little black piece that goes on, you know, underneath the grill there. I have the JDM grill as well. This works for the USDM one or the JDM version. It doesn't matter, this is exactly the same. It's very easy to install. As you can see, there's some double-sided tape here. I believe it's 3M. And it also comes with some primer and adhesion. So this actually is the same stuff that I got with my OLM exhaust finishers, same exact concept. So basically what you're gonna do is peel off the backing on the tape here and put some of this stuff on the right on the back here, so it gets a good bond with the grill, so it stays on, because I do not want this part falling off. Here's a little bit of a close-up. I did an unboxing video of this, of a whole bunch of other parts, but for this video I figured I would show you a little bit more in depth of this specific part. The carbon fiber weave is really nice. There's no defects on it or anything. It does feel a little flimsy. Not that it really needs to be robust or super strong or anything, but for the price, you know, you kind of expect it to be a little bit more, I guess, stronger feeling. But you can tell it is definitely carbon fiber. It's a nice piece. I actually did a little test fit on the grill to make sure everything looked good, and it fit right on. It covered everything, and there's no gaps or you know, parts that are popping up or anything like that. So I think this is gonna be a pretty cool addition to the car. I'm a big believer that you can add too much carbon fiber to your car. And to me, I just wanted to add some touches here and there. If you guys don't know, I have a few carbon fiber parts around the car, minus the interior. I have the Carbon Reproductions carbon fiber mirror caps. On the rear, I have the Subispeed roof spoiler. I also have the Subispeed gurney flap. I have the trim there, and I have the exhaust finishers. So I don't have too much carbon fiber around the car. I'll mention this as well. I do have, obviously, the trim, that's the stock trim, and I have carbon fiber on the steering wheel over here. So it's nothing over the top. I don't like when people add too much and it's just every single piece is carbon fiber, but I feel like I have I have some things in the interior, on the side here, in the rear, but there's nothing in the front. And I don't want to overdo it and add too much. So I have a good feeling that adding this little touch will kind of tie things in. I do eventually want to do a carbon fiber lip kit. Same style, but just have it in carbon fiber. But that's down the road. But for now, I'm happy with this one. So adding this is going to be a perfect touch, I think. So let's get it prepped. Let's get the grill over here. As you can see, it is the JDM version. Doesn't have that mustache and the holes up top that the stock one does, or the USDM one has. So basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to wipe this down. I'm going to use some Geon prep, make sure it's really clean and everything, and then get all the backing off on the tape here, put some adhesion on, and stick it on. So stay tuned. Be sure to watch the whole thing to make sure you know exactly what you're doing. If you're not careful, this stuff gets pretty sticky and you don't want to get it anywhere else on the car. So let's get to installing this on the car. All right, so this is the grill here. Basically what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna wipe this down first with some detail spray, just to kind of clean off anything that may be on the paint or on the piece here. It's pretty clean to begin with, but I just wanna make sure there's no dirt or bugs or anything that's stuck, that's gonna be forever stuck behind there. I wanna make sure that this new carbon fiber piece is sticking really well, and it doesn't fall off. So the good, you know, I always say every install is in the prep, so you want to make sure that you get it ready, so you don't have any issues down the road. After I wipe it down with a detail spray, I'm going to use some Geon prep, which is basically like an IPA. It gets rid of any grease, oil, anything left over that may interfere with the bond to the grill. detail spray here. All I'm gonna do is just spray this down quickly. Oh, not quickly, but there's no rush. I got a nice soft microfiber here. And basically I'm just gonna go around and clean in all the cracks. Make sure there's no bugs or again, there's no grime or anything stuck underneath, just because you don't want to put this on when there's all that stuff underneath, because it could fall off and you can lose it forever if you're driving down the road and you won't know until you get out of the car. And I don't want that to happen. So as you can kind of see, there was a bug kind of stuck in there. So I got that out. but you know, the car is pretty clean. It's not that dirty. But I just want to make sure I get a good cleaning of it before I put it on. The stock piece is actually pretty nice. It does have a kind of like a metallic to it. Can't really see it on camera, but it is really nice. You kind of see it here. Those aren't pebbles or anything. That's the actual metallic in the paint, which I believe is the OEM black, the OEM black paint that they use on the actual car, which is pretty cool. It's not just some basic gloss black. Yeah, so we got this cleaned off. I'm gonna spray it down with Gion prep real quick, just to make sure any of the oils or anything like that is off, and then we'll get to installing it on the car. So we got some Gion prep. This stuff is great. I use it on anytime I detail, right before I do a coating or anything like that, just to get all the polishing oils off and stuff. So spray it down heavily. And obviously you just want to make sure everything is dry before you, you know, put the piece on the car. But this is just kind of like the last step. You could go as far as clay bar this if you really want to go nuts. But I don't find the need. This JDM grill that I have, it's fairly new. I maybe got it about a year and a half ago. So it's nothing crazy. It's not as old as the car, or it's not as many miles on this as the car has. So it's in relatively good shape, which is crazy because it is a gloss black metallic kind of finish. So you would think it would chip pretty easily since it's been right on the front of the car, you know, and you do all the driving and everything and stuff flies up, but there's literally not a single rock chip in this, which is crazy now that I think of it. But yeah, so this is all ready. Just want to make sure again, it's really dry. There's no, you know, in all the cracks around here and everything, there's no residue, there's no dirt or anything. So just make sure you get in all those creases and the corners up here and wipe it down, and we are set to go. All right, so let's get it ready to get on the car. I got my microfiber down just so, you know, I'm really careful with it. I am gonna put a coating on this. I'm going to detail the car very soon. So I'm gonna do it all at once. So the whole car and every single piece has the coating on at the exact same time. So everything wears down evenly, and I know I just can't keep track of it all. So I will put something on it. For now, I'll probably just throw on some bead maker or some colonite just to kind of get an initial protection on it so it doesn't get messed up until, you know, I have the time to be able to detail. But first thing I'm gonna do, you don't wanna put this on first because this gets pretty tacky and it dries quickly. So I'm gonna take off all the backing to the double-sided tape over here. So I'm gonna try to do this quickly. I know this is not the most exciting thing to see, and usually taking this stuff off is a pain in the butt, but this seems to be coming off relatively easy. Normally when you do this kind of stuff, you want to just peel off one side and kind of do it. But I found with something that you just have to stick on, you know, right away to a specific piece and, you know, get all the corners lined up, you want to just take, I prefer just to take it all off at once. I find that I get a better fitment when I do it this way. So I've got all the backing off. Now for this, it's pretty simple. There's a little pin on top, so you just, you know, it's covered. You just turn the cap around, pop it, and you get a little hole. You don't wanna go crazy with this stuff. You just wanna put it in some areas. I'm gonna put it down the middle here, mainly because this is the part that's gonna be touching the actual grill. So I'll do some up in the corner here. It's very liquidy. You don't wanna do too much. I'll just do some drops here and there. And maybe on the bottom here. And a good thing to do, you know, it's not like glue where it's, you know, it's gonna stay in one place. It's basically like water. So you kind of just want to work it around. You don't use too much where it's gonna leak out when you install. It's gonna drip down the car. So that should be enough. You know, there is a 3M tape there, so you don't have to go too crazy. But you just want to move it around, make sure it's in all different areas. So that's basically what it looks like. It smells like just smells like glue. All right, so simply just going to line it up, make sure it doesn't drip anywhere. I think what I'm going to do is put the corners off first, kind of line it up there, and just set it into place and hold the corners down. So sorry if I'm in the way, I just want to make sure I get a good adhesion. Just want to hold it in place for a little bit, make sure it gets, you know, bonded well. And again, like I said, I did test fit on this before, and it fits really, really well. There's no gaps or anything. It doesn't pop up anywhere. It just fits really nice. And all the gaps are even and everything. You basically just want to hold it there until you feel like it has a good bond. You know, if it starts popping up in any corner or any place, you just want to hold it for a little bit to make sure it's down and seated right. But I'm pretty confident this is not going anywhere. So I guess the only bad thing is if you ever do want to sell this piece down the road, you're basically going to either have to break it off or sell it with the grill. I'm going to be obviously keeping this car for a long time, so I don't intend on removing it, but who knows. But I guess that's the only flaw of that. If you know, it's something that you want to, I guess, sell later, might be a little difficult to take off. I'm sure you'd be able to. You might be able to use a heat gun or something and kind of heat it up and get it off. But I'm not worried about that because it looks really, really sweet. All right, guys, so the install is finished. Very simple, very straightforward. The fitment is absolutely perfect. There's no gaps anywhere. There's no strange fitment issues or anything like that. The corners line up really well. They're nice and tight. None of the actual black trim on the actual grill is showing. I mean, I'm obviously up here. It doesn't wrap around here because it doesn't, you know, it just doesn't do that. It just comes up to here. But either way, you can't see anything underneath. It wraps under. The corners are nice and tight. It looks really cool, especially on lapis. I think carbon fiber on a darker color is really nice because it's nice and subtle. It doesn't really stand out too much. You know, it's not like in your face, like, hey, check out all my carbon fiber that I spent all this money on everything. I think it's a nice subtle touch, and I think it adds a nice pop of, you know, tying everything into the front end. Because like I said, I don't have anything in the front here, just on the sides and the rear and the interior as well. So this was the only place that I didn't have anything. So this is probably it that I'm going to do with the amount of carbon fiber on the front bumper. Again, I might do the lip, I guess. So that might come in the near future, as well as a side skirt. But I'm really happy with the ones I have. So I don't know yet. And they're pretty expensive. And plus the ones I do want, they're out of stock currently, so I don't know when they're going to come back in, so we'll see about that. But that's down the road, but let's not get ahead of ourselves. But I just think it looks really, it contrasts really well with the lapis. I mean, it will look good with any color, but for me, I always kind of am attracted to carbon fiber on a darker colored car, like black or something. I know it's very subtle, you don't really notice it, but that's just kind of my style, and I just prefer how kind of, it's kind of hidden, but it's like a little surprise when you get close up and see all the details. So that's it for this video, guys. Thanks for watching. Thanks for tuning in. If you guys have any questions about this specific piece, I'll link it below in the description so you guys can just click on it. It is from Subispeed. You know, I have no affiliation or sponsorship or anything like that. So, you know, I paid for it and I get nothing out of it, but it is a really nice piece. I do recommend it. So if anybody has a 15 to 17 WX or STI, wants to add some carbon fiber but doesn't want to spend a crazy amount of money, this is definitely a cool piece to add. Thanks for watching, guys. Again, be sure to like the video. Be sure to subscribe. I really do like seeing this channel grow, and I thank you all for tuning in and checking out my stuff. So that's it for this video, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.